Exgorinator here, and I know you guys are seeing this a little bit late, but this is Gore's Weekly Recap for the week of June 15th, 2015. So without further ado, let's jump into this. So guys, the first thing I want to talk about today was, no videos at the moment like I usually do. I am still doing my exams, although this week is the last week of me doing them. I literally have 3 exams left. I have 2 to do on Wednesday, which will probably be the day that you guys are seeing this. So by the time you guys are seeing this, I'll only have 1 on Friday, and then I'm done from school. That is just awesome to me. I cannot wait to leave. It's going to be so good, especially just... Well, yeah, I have tons of free time to play out the video games and, of course, make plenty of videos for you guys. I'm going to try get back on the one-a-day schedule very, very soon, or if not that, maybe even like 2 a day if I can. I've got loads of content planned. I told you guys before, I've got loads of different like series ideas, collaborations, all that kind of stuff coming in the summer, which is really not too far away till I break up. So, yeah, guys, definitely... Definitely look forward to that. And also, why there hasn't been any videos kind of on like the next topic that I want to talk about today was my new PC. I actually built it. I built it a little bit earlier than I actually expected to. I was going to wait till I fully left school and then build it. But, it was my birthday last week, I think. I don't know, 7th of June. And I got some extra PC parts, and then I actually had enough money to buy it, and I was just like... I'm really in the mood. I really want to build this thing. I was just like so excited to do it. And so yeah, I built it and it's pretty cool. I'll put a picture up on screen for you guys so you can see kind of what it looks like. I really do like the cases, the NZXT H440, and I really love the side panel. The clear side panel, so you can see inside the computer. You can kind of see when it's running, and you can see like all like the water pump illuminated, all that kind of stuff. It was a really fun project. It did take like 2 full days to get everything like fully set up. Me and my dad, when I say we, because I wanted to build it with him, because it was a really fun project, and I probably could have done it on my own. But, just really handy to have someone else there. And also, like I said, it is a lot of fun to build your own PC, especially guys who are into, like, tech and stuff like that. But anyway, on Saturday, it was about, midday, about 12 o'clock. And we started building it. And, we was doing absolutely fine installing everything. We had, like, a guide going on the iPad, just to watch along to. Although, to be fair, I kind of knew what I was doing because I've watched loads of guides already. And I have a rough idea of how to build PCs. And so does my dad because he's, me and him have, upgraded my old PC plenty of times before, like, with new graphics cards and, new power supplies and stuff like that. So we had a rough idea what we was doing, so that was going absolutely fine, and it's fine. I did like lots of nice and neat cable management, and it looked really freaking cool. Went to go turn it on, and it didn't boot up. Literally, there was nothing, and I was shitting my pants because I thought some kind of part was broken or something. Although I wasn't completely scared because there was definitely power going to the motherboard and, all the parts. Because, all, the lights were on for, the water pump and stuff like that. So, I wasn't really scared, but I was like, oh, for God's sake, what's wrong now? I've done all this cable management and now I got to, pull it all out and look what's up with it. But it just turned out that there was a few things that weren't fully plugged into like the power supply, but that still took us like a couple of hours to find out, which troubleshooting and trying to figure out what's wrong, and it was just a few cables. So yeah, that was pretty cool. Then we kind of took it up to my room to plug it into like a monitor, and then install Windows and stuff. So I plugged that in, turned it on, loaded up perfectly fine, fan spinning, everything fine, but there's no display on the monitor. And it's like, for fuck's sake, what is wrong now? And it was like 9 o'clock at that point, so I was like, yeah, I've had enough, fuck it, I'll do it tomorrow. So woke up on Sunday, literally it took me like 10 minutes. I literally just found out that the plug on the graphics card wasn't plugged into the power supply either. It'd been like pulled out because it's pretty messy behind the back of the back side panel, because obviously I've done lots of cable management on the front, but the back, just all the wires are kind of stashed away because you can't really see them. So it was pretty hard to see that and then try and like replug it back in. But I did it and I booted it up, and then all of Sunday I just like installing Windows and all the programs I had on my old PC so that I can mainly, you know, like make videos for you guys. And this is actually the first video I'm making on my new PC, so I can't wait to see how the render times fare and stuff like that, just to give you guys an idea. Like, I haven't done any benchmarking or anything like that. I'll probably do some, you know, some benchmarking and stuff when I decide to, like, try and overclock my CPU. And, you know, then I can get, like, some comparison scores to what it was before and then what it is when I overclock it. But for now, I just play Skyrim just to see how it fare. And, you know, it ran, like, plus 60 FPS on Ultra, you know, the best settings and everything. That I know that isn't really a very good scale to give you guys, but that's just an idea that, you know, it's pretty good for gaming, it should be pretty good for video editing, right? I can't wait to see how quickly it can render this channel update when I, you know, edit it and go to do that for you guys. But anyway, that's pretty much it for the topics for today, guys. If you do want to get updates on my PC and just more in real life stuff, then I'd recommend following me on Twitter at itsthegorinator, link always in the description. So you know, that's if you want, you know, daily updates on my life rather than these 1 weekly channel updates. Anyway, onto the news, which I do now for those of you guys that missed last week's Gore's weekly recap. I now do the new stuff, and there's a lot of news today. Okay, this will probably be quite a longer Gore's weekly recap than normal, just because like there's been E3 and the Steam sale, which is about the only things I got to note down there. But there's a ton of stuff from E3, ton of new games and just trailers and stuff that I want to go through. So, you know, in case you guys missed it, to keep you guys up to date, that's what it's for. Just give you guys a weekly recap on stuff on the channel, on news, and, you know, just stuff like that. So anyway, first things first, let's start with the smaller thing here, the Steam sale. Yeah. That's pretty cool. You know, Steam does a summer sale every year or so. Yeah, it is every year. And, you know, they have a bunch of, like, ridiculously cheap games on sale. And you can pick up so many. It is awesome. I bought a lot of games. Okay, guys, you will be seeing a lot of kind of indie game content very soon in the summer. Like I'm saying, there's going to be a lot of stuff coming in the summer. So look forward to that. So that's pretty cool. They also had this, like, monster game thing where you like you get coins for killing the monsters and you can buy like upgrades and stuff like that. I participate because it's just automated. Once you get a few upgrades, you can just leave it running in the background. You don't even have to have Steam open, and it, like, I don't know, it helps the community, I guess. It unlocks extra deals. It also gives me some trading cards and stuff like that. Anyway, yeah, that was the Steam sale. Bought loads of games, so guys, look forward to indie game content coming very soon. Now, onto the extremely large section of this video. I'm going to cover just about all of the E3 news for you guys, or at least all the stuff that has happened so far. There may be some more stuff that has happened by the time you guys are seeing this, because obviously, you know, making my videos a day beforehand, I can't keep exactly up to date, but I'm going to keep you guys as up to date as I can. So starting things off, as E3 kicked off with the Bethesda conference. Bethesda is the company that made like Skyrim and Fallout, for those of you who don't know. And that was probably one of the best conferences in my opinion. Now, I didn't watch any of these live. I watched most of the Bethesda conference on, you know, like, you know, just not live. And the others I'd, you know, like, just watched the trailers for and, you know, just researched on. So, there you go. I haven't watched, like, the full things. So, but I'll give you guys a rough idea of some of the stuff that was announced and that they did on stage. So, anyway, at the Bethesda conference, probably the biggest thing, or at least, no. No, I'll get onto the biggest thing in just a second. At least, this is all in my opinion, obviously. But anyway, one of the biggest things that they did show was some Fallout 4 gameplay. So, they actually announced Fallout 4 about a week before E3 or so, which obviously created a lot of hype for that. And there was some gameplay, which was pretty cool. I'm actually really excited for Fallout 4. Definitely will pick it up on launch for... I don't know if I should get it for Xbox One or PC. Guys, What would you want to see gameplay on? What would you want to see Gore plays on? The Xbox One or the PC? Obviously, you know, PC is going to be better graphics, mods and stuff, all that kind of cool stuff. And now that I've got a brand new PC that can actually handle those kind of games, That is a viable option, but then again, I do like getting it on Xbox One, because the main reason I'd get it for console still for my Xbox is just because I like getting achievements, okay? That's me, I'm a bit of an achievement hunter, so that would be the main reason I get it for Xbox One. But guys, let me know down in the comments below, do you want to see gameplay on Xbox games, PC games, or do you not care as long as you see the game and me playing it? So there you go. Yeah, there was some Fallout 4 gameplay, that was pretty cool. Guys, I'll link most of this stuff down in the description below in the like news section. Just, you know, open it up and you'll find all these like trailers and gameplay links and stuff like that, so you guys can check them out for yourself and see what I'm talking about. Fallout 4 will be coming on November 10th, 2015 this year. So that's pretty cool. Can't wait for that. There's a lot of good games coming out in November, so I'm really excited for that. Well, then again, that's usually the case. They always release like all the amazing games in November, which sucks because I never have enough money to buy them all, but there you go, hey. Yeah, they also announced that there's a free iOS and Android game called Fallout Shelter, which is, you know, you may be like, oh, God's sake, another, you know, phone game thing to get more money. No, it's not actually like that. There's not many microtransactions. There's only like a very small amount, and it doesn't force them upon you at all. But yeah, Fallout Shelter is free. Very, very fun. I've been playing it actually, and it's got me even more excited for Fallout 4. Basically, you just like build your own Fallout shelter, and you have to like manage like food and water and power resources and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it's pretty fun. Definitely go check it out. It's free. So yeah. You guys, most of you guys should be able to get that if you choose to. They also showed some Doom gameplay, which, you know, it's Doom. If you like Doom, there you go. I may get that. I don't know. Anyway, it's coming out in 2016, spring 2016. So that's quite a way off yet. But, yeah, I remember playing Doom back in the day on my PS1 or PS2, I don't know. But anyway, I'll probably pick that up at some point. It did look kind of cool. I didn't watch the full thing because obviously there was a lot of research to do for all these things. So I'm going to try speed up a little bit. There's also the Elder Scrolls Legends card game. Yes, they have made the Elder Scrolls a card game now. They've made a card thing, which, you know, I'm not really too interested in, to be honest. But then again, you couldn't really expect them to make a brand new Elder Scrolls game when they're making Fallout 4, a massive open world. And also, onto the next thing, Dishonored 2, which is probably the thing I was most excited about. That Dishonored is getting a sequel, and yeah, I just really like Dishonored. I love the art style and the story, and you know, I just love that game. It was pretty cool, and it's going to be really interesting to see how they expand upon the Dishonored universe. So I'm really looking forward to playing that one. So yeah, that's going to be coming in 2016. But to keep you guys waiting, to, you know, kind of bridge the gap, if you will, there will be Dishonored Definitive Edition as well. Dishonored the Definitive Edition coming in 2015, which is, you know, just obviously going to be a remastered Dishonored for Xbox One and PS4, because obviously it's still on PC. But yeah, so, you know, like enhanced graphics and all the DLC content. You guys have seen plenty of remastered bundle games before. I will probably pick that up because, you know, I was a massive Dishonored fan. I haven't played it in ages, actually. I was actually going to buy it in the Steam sale, and I was like, wait a minute, it's coming out on Xbox One. I want to put it on Xbox One and get them achievements. So, yeah, I will be getting that one in whenever that comes out, probably in September, October, November kind of time, you know, the usual time where all the games get released. Now, onto the Microsoft conference. So, there was a lot of games that they kind of showed off for this one, which is good, opposed to, I think it was last year. Wait, was it last year? I don't know. Anyway, you know, because it was gaming focused this time, which is nice to see, rather than, you know, just media entertainment focused. So, yeah, one of the main things probably from the Microsoft conference was the Xbox One will have backwards compatibility with the 360 very, very soon, which will basically mean you guys that on Xbox One will be able to play hundreds of 360 games on your Xbox One, which is pretty cool. It's not like streamed, I don't think. I'm pretty sure you just download it on your Xbox One as they come available. Obviously, you can't play any game on there because, you know, they have to do some stuff on the Xbox end of things. But once the games that you want come available, you providing you've purchased them on 360 as well. If you have it digitally on 360, you can just download it straight to your Xbox One when it becomes available. And if you have it on disc, I think you put it in your 360 and like install it or something. I don't know, but basically you have to have either have a digital download on your 360, like tied to your account, or the disc to put in, and then you can download it to your Xbox One, which is pretty cool. That also means one of the coolest things, especially for me with still lots of friends, like Max, for instance, who's still on 360. You can play with your friends on 360 on your Xbox One. How cool is that? Like, I'd have to get a 360 copy of GTA, and I put it in my 360, and then I install it on Xbox One. That means I could play with Max on my Xbox One, technically. Like, that is pretty cool. So, yeah, I'm looking really excited for that. Unless Max gets an Xbox One anytime soon, that would be even better. But there you go. That is coming later on this year. Another big thing they announced was a brand new Xbox controller called the Xbox Elite Controller. It's going to be costing $150, and basically it's like a SCUF, but made by Microsoft, obviously. So there's going to be stuff like customizable thumbsticks, so you could have like concave or convex thumbsticks. It'll be up to 4 programmable buttons on the back, so you know, you can remap them to like A or B or, you know, whatever. There's going to be a 3.5mm audio jack instead of the stupid proprietary port on the the current controller, which means you have to buy like an adapter to use like any headset. Now you'll just be able to use like anyone, even like PC ones and stuff like that, so that's gonna be pretty cool. This is going to be optional trigger stops, so you know, for like FPS games, you can like stop the triggers halfway, so you don't have to press it down nearly as much. You can have like a bit of a quicker trigger finger. There's like a really, really weird D-pad, which isn't really a cross-shaped D-pad. It's more of like a dome thing, which you can press in any direction. Anyway, guys, all this stuff is like optional and interchangeable, and you can customize it how you want. So that's pretty cool. If you guys, it's probably cheaper than a SCUF. I'm not too sure how much a SCUF costs. I feel like $150 is cheaper than a SCUF controller. But anyway, it's pretty cool that Microsoft are doing that, their own like customizable controller. So I may pick one up at some point, maybe if the price drops. Probably not at $150, but there you go. Now onto loads and loads of game releases, or, you know, just game stuff by Microsoft. So there's the Halo 5 Guardians gameplay demo and also a Warzone trailer. Halo 5 Guardians will be coming out on October 27th, 2015, I believe. My dog is barking in the background. I do apologize. God damn it, people. Why you gotta be loud? I don't know why I said people. It's a dog. It's an animal. God sake, bruh. Oh my god, shut the fuck up! So anyway, now that my dog has finally shut up, the rest of the stuff. So, there was also a Gears of War Ultimate Edition announced. So that's going to be the original Gears of War remastered for Xbox One, coming on August 25th, 2015. So that is very soon, actually. That will kind of bridge the gap between, you know, like now kind of time and, like November and October and that kind of time where all the games come out. So that'd be pretty cool. I may pick that up because I've never actually played a Gears of War game. Interesting to see what it's like. There's also Gears of War 4 announced. So that's pretty cool for those of you that are fans of the Gears of War series. That'll be coming in holiday 2016. There's also some Dark Souls 3 stuff, which is supposedly the last one in the series. I'm pretty sure Dark Souls is that like really kind of tough game where you die a lot and you have to fight like massive, really like ridiculously healthed monsters. I never actually played any, but there you go. That's good for you guys that are interested in that series as well. That'll be coming in early 2016. There's also some Forza 6 stuff. There's a Forza 6 gameplay trailer, and that is coming in September 15th, 2015. So that's coming, you know, this year, end of this year. There's also the Division gameplay premiere trailer coming in 2016 at some point. The Division, that actually looks like a really cool game. I'll probably get that one. I really do like post-apocalyptic scenarios. I don't know why. I just really like them. So the Division, I'll probably enjoy that quite a lot. There's also Rainbow Six Siege. There was a trailer for that one. That'll be coming on October the 6th, 2015. And of course, Rise of the Tomb Raider. There was a gameplay demo trailer. I don't know if I could really call it gameplay. It's more like some cinematic stuff. Anyway, that'll be coming on November 10th, 2015. So, like I said, guys, most of these things coming at the end of this year. So, prepare your wallets. because yeah, there's gonna be a lot to choose from, and I'm sure I will be broke by, you know, by the time Christmas comes around. Guys, most of the trailers will be linked in the description if you want to check them out for yourself, or at least some of the more interesting ones, such as the next one on the list here, which is basically there's going to be a HoloLens version of Minecraft. And for those of you who don't know what HoloLens is, instead of like Oculus Rift, where it's virtual reality, where you put the like headset thing on, you know, over your eyes, and then you can't see anything of the outside world, you're in this virtual world. Augmented reality is where, like, you can still see the rest of the world, kind of like glasses, if you will, but then it puts stuff in the world to basically make your life more convenient. So, basically, it's going to be like Minecraft in real life. You'll be able to, they showed it off, like some kind of tech demo thing. Actually, looked really cool. You could, like, place a Minecraft TV screen anywhere you want, on like a wall or something. You can just play it, or you can then like actually make a 3D copy of the world you're playing in on like a table or something, and you can like navigate it and look like what's under your village and stuff like that. It was pretty nuts. I definitely recommend, if you guys have a bit of spare time after this video, open that description and definitely check the HoloLens version of Minecraft out. That was really, really cool, and kind of like an insight of to where the future of technology is going, I guess. So yeah, that was pretty nuts. Onto the EA conference, and there was a decent amount of stuff I hear. There's Mirror's Edge Catalyst. There was an announcement trailer for that one. Now, it isn't a sequel, supposedly. It's not continuing on the story, but it's kind of like more of a reboot for the Mirror's Edge franchise, I guess. That's going to be released for Xbox One, PS4, and PC on February 23rd, 2016. So that one's quite a while off. You won't be able to pick that one up this holiday. There was also one that a lot of people were really excited about, Star Wars Battlefront. There was some multiplayer gameplay. Oh my god, you guys should definitely go check this one out as well. All I can really say is that was lightsabers and guns and just lots of firing a laser pew pew action. It was pretty cool. Definitely go check that one out if you guys are fans of the Star Wars Battlefront series. That'll be coming on November 20th, 2015, end of this year, so look forward to that one. There was also Mass Effect Andromeda, the next in the Mass Effect franchise. It doesn't look like it's going to be continuing on the Mass Effect storyline, because obviously there's Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3. So now, Mass Effect Andromeda, I believe, yeah, it's exploring Andromeda, I guess. So it's going to be exploring a new kind of world within the Mass Effect universe. There was an announcement trailer for that one. That'll be coming holiday 2016. And also, of course, it's EA, so lots and lots of sports games stuff, which I don't give two shits about, okay? You know, Madden, NBA, FIFA, you guys can look that up if you want. I don't give a shit about sports games, so yeah, there you go. On to the Ubisoft conference. Now, a lot of this stuff is starting to overlap because, of course, Sony and Microsoft display a lot of stuff that the game developers kind of show off as well. So the only kind of main new thing I got down here on the Ubisoft list is Assassin's Creed Syndicate. There was a cinematic trailer showing off one of the protagonists, Evie, who is, yeah, the other protagonist is her twin, Jacob, yeah, it kind of just showed her off in action. Lots of fighting, lots of showing off the weapons and stuff, giving you stats about them, how you can use them to brutally murder people or just like throw at a wall and distract people. That'll be coming October 23rd, 2015. And finally, for the E3 news, for the Sony conference, it looks like Call of Duty has now partnered with Sony. I believe that's that was kind of rumored, but now it looks pretty much official, because rather than there being any Call of Duty stuff at the Microsoft conference, there was actually some Black Ops 3 stuff at the Sony conference, and they actually showed off some multiplayer gameplay. There was a multiplayer gameplay trailer, and it was pretty nuts. I'll definitely link that one down in the description for you guys to go check out. It's kind of like the first multiplayer gameplay we've seen without, you know, obviously we saw something like a teaser trailer, just a few like very short clips, but now you can actually see the multiplayer in action with the HUD and everything like that. I'll say a few things about it. It was very colorful, which is nice to see. It wasn't like whitewashed or anything like that, or, you know, like gray or brown looking. It was very colorful and vibrant, which I guess kind of is kind of like Black Ops 2. So that is nice to see. Very fast paced, I will say, but nowhere near as hectic as AW's as Advanced Warfare. You could jump like pretty high up and stuff like that, but it seems most of this is going to be like ground based and stuff like that. Ground based movement, of course, you can run on walls, but it's not like you're going to be flying through the air, so you won't lose track of people so easily as in like Advanced Warfare. So that should I'm sure that'd be a better experience for most people. Yeah, there was lots of explosions, which is very nice to see, and also it looks like you get kills very quickly, or you get killed very quickly as well. I don't know, that's just something I picked up on. Of course, that's only like a trailer, and the game is still in development. It's still got like a good 5 months-ish in development, so that may change, but it looked like you just kill people very quickly. But then again, if you're moving about very quickly, then that's kind of like to counter out that one. And finally, at like the end of the trailer, after like obviously they showed the release date and stuff like that, they actually showed off a brief segment of the gunsmith, where you can customize your attachments and your own camos on your gun, where you make your own camo, and that looked pretty cool, not gonna lie. You guys should definitely watch till the end of the trailer if you go check it out, so you can see the brief segment of that one. That actually looked really cool, and I'm a big fan of customizability, so that'd be nice for me to see at least. And that will be coming on November 6th, 2015. So, yeah, like first week of November, I guess. So, look forward to that one as well. Oh, and of course, before I skip over this, there's also some Uncharted 4 gameplay. So, I've never actually played any Uncharted because I've always been on Xbox. I may get a PS4 at some point, and then I may pick that game up. But for those of you that are fans of the Uncharted series, go check out the gameplay for that one. Like I said, guys, all this kind of stuff will be linked in the news segment of the description. But anyway, guys, that's pretty much it for today. What's coming up on the channel this week, Josh? Well, I will say that it's probably going to be a lot of videos on all the games I bought during the Steam sale. I bought lots of indie game stuff, so definitely look forward to Gore Plays. Lots of Gore Plays, basically. Maybe not this week, but, you know, just throughout the summer. All that kind of stuff, guys. Look forward to it, because it's going to be very good indeed. I hope you guys do have a great rest of your week. If you enjoyed the video, smash that like button, and of course, subscribe for more content from myself. Thank you guys so much for watching. Now it's time to see how quickly my PC can render this thing and can do the video editing magic. Love you guys' faces, and I'll see you guys next time.